Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is The World Away. We've now got issue 25 of the Hero Collector and Eagle Moss release of Build the Ghostbusters Ecto-1. Now issue 25 consists of stages 91 to 94 and I have got my little PKE detection meter here because we do have a little problem. I'm going to tell you about that now. The problem is all to do with pack 91. Now in pack 91, as you can see, we've got a door here. Now we don't need any of the vehicle because all of pack 25 is going to be about putting things in the door, the mechanics, the window mechanisms, everything, door trims. Trouble is that this door has got a hole for a wing mirror, and we do have the base of the wing mirror just here. But the thing is, in the film, it didn't have a wing mirror on this side. So Eagle Moss and Hero Collector are actually replacing this whole door. Now that door is going to be coming, I believe, towards stages 107. So we're looking a good three issues for that before that comes. So everything, absolutely everything we do today, I'm going to have to take apart to put on the new door. But it's going to be pretty much similar when we do get the new door. Well, it's going to be exactly the same, actually. You're just going to have a door without a wing mirror on it. But I am going to do all of these today to show you what that looks like. To that end, I will be putting the sticker on the door as well. But as you can see, I do have Mike Lane's door transfer kit over there. So I'll be fitting that when the real door does actually come. But if you want to get this for yourself, I'll put a link down the bottom here. If you're in the US, follow the US link. And if you're in the UK, follow the UK link. You can get this all the way from pack one. And you can build it up to the stage that we're up to on there. But without further ado, let's get cracking. So as you can see, stage 91, we've got the door, we're going to be fitting the wing mirror and the handle, and then we're going to be putting the hinge on, and then we're going to be putting the sticker on. That's all there is to do in that stage. So I'm using the Partwork Upgrades cushioned mat here because I don't want to mark this door, even though this door obviously is going to be swapped out anyway. So the first thing I'm going to do is going to put the wing mirror support in, looking like this. Now this is what's not going to be appearing when we get the replacement, but that just goes in like that. And it's held in from the other side with a screw, which is a TP screw. And that screw's just in the middle of this section here. So make sure that's in nice and tight. And there we go, we've got a wing mirror support in for a wing mirror which isn't going to exist. We have then got the door handle looking like that. That's just going to go in here and that's held in with an AM screw. Now, bearing in mind that I'm going to have to take all of these out afterwards, it is handy to make sure I remember what screws go in where, because this is going to look quite detailed when we finished. And there we go, that's the handle in place. Turn it over here and then we've just got the hinges to put in. And as you can see on the hinge, we've got a little R there. That should be facing towards the exterior of the door. So it's going to be this way around. That's just going to go in like that. Held in place by a brace, which goes just over the top there. That's what the brace looks like. Then we've got two washers that are going to go just over the top of that. So you'll have one here and one just on the other side there. And then lastly, we're going to hold all of that into place with some RM screws. I want this door hinge to be quite tight. So even though we are going to be taking this apart, I will follow my best practice and just put that in a little bit of oil there, just to help drive that in. But that's the first one. If anything, it will make it easier to take out afterwards. And here's the second one. All we've got to do then is turn it over and apply the Ghostbusters sticker here. Now I'm doing this completely freehand because, I mean, we are going to change this later on, but I've pretty much got it like they've got it in the picture there. Go on, brave doing that freehand, aren't I? And there we go. That's the Ghostbusters sticker on the right hand side door, which looks like that. Mike Lane stickers, just so you can see, they are a lot smaller, and there is a template in there which is going to help line up for that. You can get that from Mike Lane's Mods, and I have put a link on the screen for that to show you what to do with all the instructions, how to fit that. But they look just like that if you want to use that. But that is all there is to do in that stage. Now, stage 92 is the right front door, window frame and skirting. As you see, we've got a lot of trim to put on here. We've got a window piece to put in here and the frame to go over that. So once we've got all of this trim on, that's what that's going to look like. So the first thing we need to do is take this part of the window with this red sill here, and we have got another sill to go round the side. Now, this has got a lug just in the top there, which is going to go into that hole. So it's actually going to go in like this. And then these parts are going to fit flush together, so when a screw goes through there, it's going to hold both of those together. We could just leave that to one side for a second and bring over the door. So we're then going to take the window, which looks like that, with the tinting on it. And as you can see, we've got two lugs just at the top and the bottom. That's going to match the two lugs that we've got there. So it's just going to fit in nice and flat onto that section like that there. Then we're going to be putting the frame just on the top of that, lining up the sills so that they go this side of the door. I'll get this in place and show you what that looks like. So that's in like that there. I'm going to turn it over and we're going to be holding that together with OP screws. Now, it's basically OP screws at the top, but I want to hold this section in first at the bottom where that sill was that we put originally at the start of this stage. Those screws are DM screws. So I'll drop that in a little bit of oil, and that's going to hold the first bit of frame in. Got another DM screw just to go into the other side there. My window's fallen out. Let's just put that back in. Make sure it's in the channel there. Excellent. And then we just need to put OP screws into the four holes that you can see there. And it's going to take four of these. So that's one. One down the bottom here. That's number two. One on this side is number three. And finally, the one over here, number four. So that should now look like that. And the good thing is this window is able to tilt to open. I think that's quite a clever little feature there. Putting it this way around, we're now going to be putting some trim on here. Now, I'll still be able to take it apart once the trim's on. So I am going to be putting the trim on. It's going to go on this section here. So it's just adhesive again. Take the backing off. Put the flat end into this side first. Lining up the holes. Make sure that's in the channel there. So that's the first bit of trim on. The second bit of trim is going down this side. So again, take the adhesive off, pressing up this side now against the edge, and then push that down the channel. So we've got a nice corner on that. And then finally, we've got this section here, which is just going to be pushing into the lugs that we can just see there. So this will be going on top and pushed in just like that. And that is all there is to do in that stage. Now, stage 93, we've got the right front window and door lock. So we're going to be putting some trim in the inside here, starting the braces for the outside of the door, making the door catch here, putting the little sill on that's going to stop the window from scratching as it goes up and down. So taking the door like this, the first thing we need is the trim that's going around in the inside here. That looks just like this, and quite simply that's just going to go over the lugs there, and it's going to be held in with an SM screw. I refer to that as the singular, but I did mean two screws. So we've got one this side here, and we've got one just on the other side there. We're then going to put the bulkheads into each side of the door here, and we're going to use this round one first. That's just going to go over the lugs here and here, so that's going to go on just like, oops, get it in, just like that there. And the other side here, this one over here, is just going to go same way but over the lugs here and here. Now they're going to be held in with DM screws. Now I've put one in to hold it, but I'm going to take that one back out because I think it is going to help to put a bit of oil on this to get them to go in nice and easy, because that first one I put in was quite tricky. But as you see, with a bit of oil, that goes in no problems at all. So I'll do the same just on the other side here. See how much detail is just on one door. And I'm going to have to swap this out again soon. Everything I'm adding is a job that I'm going to have to undo and redo afterwards. But this doesn't affect everyone. So if you're watching this in the future, chances are that that wing mirror here is not on your one. If it isn't, then you don't have to swap it out. That's only for subscribers that do have this wing mirror on there. But that is that part in. I'm just getting all these parts out now because we're going to make the door catch mechanism here, which means we need to take the little catch or the lock here and put the spring just down the end. This whole section then is going to go with the long side into the top of this catch here, just like that. And then we need to get this into this position here so that the top of this section comes out of the hole that you can see at the side. So I'll get this in. This is where things go off in all directions, as you can probably tell. Just putting this onto the brace where it's going to go. So it kind of like looks like that. I am holding it with my hands at the moment and it is hurting a little bit, but it is going to be held in with a DM screw. So I'll get one of them loaded up. I've got the screw in there to hold that in. And I'll screw that all the way in, making sure it's nice and tight, because that's supporting the whole of that lock there. And as you can see, the lock's in and it's got a spring to it, and the spring moves when we do that. That's going to keep the door shut. All we got to do then is just on this sill here, just on the top, we're going to again put these little felt pads here, which are going to stop it scratching the window when that goes up and down. Now there's no definitive place for these to go, just make sure that the felt doesn't go above this silver line here. And I'm placing this on with my tweezers. So that's one. And this one here is number two. So they're on, and that's all there is to do in that stage. Now in the final stage, we're going to be doing the window lever mechanism. So we're going to be attaching cogs, the window winding handle, putting all of those handles in, some trim for the inside door, getting the window in. So we're going to have the trim going on the door. So by the end of it, we'll have a working window which will go up and down. So the first thing we need is the door trim, which looks like this. I'm going to lay that down that way. And then we want the winder for the window, which looks like that. Very similar to the door handle, but this has a knob at the end rather than a straight bit, as you can see there. So I'll put that to one side. This is just going to go into the hole there. Turn it over. And then we've got the cog here to put over the top. It is shaped, so it can only go in one way. But there we go, that's the cog in. But that's going to be held in with a KM flanged screw. So I've got that here. And I'll get that on nice and tight. So now when I'm operating the windows, you can see that cog turns. We've got two more cogs to put on now. We've got a bigger one and a smaller one. It's this smaller one first that we need with the gear on top as well. That's going to go interlocked and underneath it. Like that. Then we've got this bigger one here, which has got a tab on this side here. We want those tabs to be upright, and they're going to go next to it onto this section just there. So now when I operate the winder, as you can see, they all turn. Now both of these cogs are going to be held in with screws, but the smaller one is going to be held in with a HP screw. The larger one's going to be held in with a UP screw. So I'll do the HP screw first into the smaller one. Nice and tight. And then a UP screw for the larger one. Now this is a flange screw. So the screw looks like that. It's just going to go in here. You don't want it too tight. You want it still to be able to operate. So as you can see, that operates no problems at all. Now we're going to be taking this little handle here, which has got a semicircular pattern. That's just going to go into this hole that we can just see there. Now this is only a push to fit, but it can only go in one way. So I'm just going to line this up and push that in. That will hold itself in like that. We then want to take the door handle, which looks like that. I showed you at the start of this build. And that's going to go into the hole that we can just see down the bottom there. So that's going to go in here like this. And it is going to face towards the other handles here. That's going to be held in with an EP screw, which I've got here. That goes through that hole. And there we go. That's the handles on the door trim there. We're then going to make the armrest, which comes in two pieces here, and all we need to do is push the lugs into the holes here to make that one piece. So line it up and then push them together. So that's now one piece. This is going to attach to the door just on this side here. So we have got a large lug and a small one. Turn it over, and that's going to be held in once again with an EP screw. So make that nice and tight. That will keep the handle in. And there we go. Now the door's looking like that. Now we're going to start putting the window in. So I'm just going to wind this mechanism round until I've got this at an angle that's pointing probably towards 11 o'clock and 5 o'clock, these bits here. And I'm going to be taking the window from the last stage and this point here. This is going to go into the window like that. Turn it over, and this side here is going to be held in with a UP screw. Again, that's one of the flange screws. Now this will stop the window escaping. Doesn't have to be too tight because you want that to be able to move in there. And then the other side of this is going to go onto the two points of the cog or the gear there, but this is going to be held in with IP screws. So here's the first one. These ones you do want to make sure are tight. And here's the second one. And then quite simply, we're just going to bring the door back across now. Turn this over. Now, before we put this on, one thing I did forget is we have got some sills to put on again, which are just going to go onto this leading edge here. So I'll put them on now. And again, I am using my tweezers to help me with that. That's the first one. I can just move the window out the way, as you can see, to get the second one in. You would have done this before putting the window in. That's just me doing things completely the wrong way around. And there's the second one in. So, what we've got to do now is line up the window on this side here with the door and then push the door into place over the lugs. Excellent, and that's everything in place. So now I'm going to hold it in my hand when I operate the window. As you can see, it goes up and it goes down. No problems at all. But we do need to hold this door card into place, and to do that, we're going to use DM screws. We'll drop these in a little bit of oil. Four screws this is going to take. So one in this corner over here, the opposite corner down here, and then just the last two here. Now there is still going to be some trim panels to go on here, but that's going to be at another stage. Once again, the window goes up and down. It's very good, actually. It's very smooth. But that is all there is to do in that stage, and that is all there is to do in that pack. So remember, if you don't have this wing mirror on the door, you're not going to have to redo this, but they are going to be sending the door outers again in issue 107 for us that have got that wing mirror to actually replace that door. So everything I've just done there, I've got to take apart, but don't worry, that's not going to be on video. But if you want to get this for yourself, once again, put the link down here for the Hero Collector site. If you're in the US, follow the US link. If you're in the UK, follow the UK link. Other than that, I really do hope you liked the video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, click that subscribe button and the bell. You'll be notified when a new video's out. Other than that, take care.